£100 fine.
Thank you. Well done.
She's ill.
Mom, I'm driving. Can you believe it? They let me off. They actually let me off. I love you. Talk to you. Defend and return to decent society.
Thank you.
the prison ship sail loud against the sky. For she'll wait and hope and pray for love in Botany Bay. It's a lonely round the fields of Athene Rye. Love, light appears of Athene Rye, where once he watched the small free birds fly. Our love was on the wing, we had dreams and songs to sing. It's a lonely round the fields of Athene Rye. By a lonely prison wall, I heard a young man calling. Nothing matters, Mary, when you're free. I get the fine and the crown, I rebel and jar us down. You must raise our child with dignity.
Veronica Guerin's writing turned the tide in the drug war. Her murder galvanized Ireland into action. Thousands of people took to the streets in weekly anti-drug marches, which drove the dealers out of Dublin and forced the drug barons underground. Within a week of her death, during an emergency session of Parliament, the government altered the Constitution of the Republic of Ireland to allow the High Court to freeze the assets of suspected drug barons. That same year, the Criminal Assets Bureau, CAB, was formed and given the power to access and seize unexplained wealth from suspected criminals. Charles Bowden turned state's evidence and became the first person in Irish history to be entered into the Witness Protection Programme. Brian Meehan was sentenced to life imprisonment for the murder of Veronica Guerin, and his assets were seized by the CAB. Eugene Holland was sentenced to 20 years in prison for drug trafficking. His assets were seized by CAB. John Traynor escaped to Portugal and continues to fight extradition to Ireland on charges of murder. His assets were seized by the CAB. After a long extradition battle, John Gilligan was brought back to Ireland from England and sentenced to 28 years in prison for drug trafficking. His assets were seized by CAB. By the following year, crime rates had dropped 15%. Everyone in the Republic of Ireland remembers where they were when they heard that Veronica Guerin had been murdered on the Naas Road.
My love, more dear.